Since biblical times, man has witnessed and recorded strange manifestations in the sky and speculated on the possibilities of visitors from another world. Today, from the skies of California, the fields of Kansas, the rice paddies of the Orient, the air lanes of the world, come persistent reports of UFOs, unidentified flying objects which we have come to know as flying saucers. In Dayton, Ohio, the Air Intelligence Command gathers and sifts data from all quarters of the globe. 97% of the objects prove on investigation to be of natural origin, but 3% still are listed as unknown. The Air Force is aware of the widely held belief that some of these could be flying saucers from another planet. While there is nothing conclusive in the evidence, the probing and digesting of information about UFOs continues unceasingly. As a result, headquarters of the Hemispheric Defense Command in Colorado Springs issued an order. All military installations are to fire on sight at any flying objects not identifiable. But even as they did so, the military wondered whether their scientific know-how and their best weapons would be effective in any battle of the Earth versus the flying saucers.
Because of recent scientific advances, it is now possible to realize an ancient dream, the exploration of outer space. To prepare for this great stride forward, we are assembling data on conditions at atmospheric levels beyond those hitherto explored. To collect the necessary data, unmanned automatic observation posts are being sent up in multiple stage rockets to a distance hundreds of miles above the Earth's surface. There, swinging in endless orbits around our planet, will be 12 tiny man-made satellites, or moons. They will report to us by radio, thus providing primary information needed to prepare the way for our ascent into space. The effects of gravitational loss, showers of meteoric dust, the fierce and undiluted heat of the sun, the cosmic radiation, all will be studied and analyzed. At the present time, we have launched 10 of the artificial satellites, or birds as we call them. Do you hear something?
Hear what? I don't hear.
Shh, listen.
Was a saucer. A flying saucer?
Well, we saw what appeared to be a flying saucer. That's all we can say.
We saw it. We heard it, both of us. What more do we need to know?
Well, we have to have time to think, to evaluate this, before we sound off.
Let me have a light. Of course, it wasn't a saucer at all. I had to shake like this all the time.
General Hanley, reporting to Project Skyhook. Now, make it fast, will you? I'm in a hurry.
Nobody allowed in, sir. There's a rocket taking off now.
That's what I want to stop. Let me speak to Dr. Russell Marvin.
Number 12, okay for takeoff.
West gate to bunker number 2.
There's no rocket man from way back. I'd rather watch from ground level.
Dr. Marvin. Dr. Marvin.
Marvin here.
You getting ready for a scene?
Look. What are those lights?
They're what the pilots call fool lights.
St. Elmo's fire in ancient times. Superstitious regard them as omens of things to come. The best science has been able to make out of them is that they're electric particles agitated by moving air. Same principle as the Aurora Borealis.
There have been so many around the project the last couple of days, we all just take them for granted.
Observation Tower A, come in. Evans, radar to Tower A.
Observation Tower A, Sergeant Nash.
UFO due west, approaching fast.
What does it look like?
Can't tell yet. I'll call when I get a better reading on my scope.
Do that.
As you were, Sergeant.
Unidentified flying object reported due west, sir. Probably a buzzard. Sergeant Nash, Observation Tower A. What? Forget it, Walters. This is no time for gags. It's 2 minutes to zero. Sentry at West Gate has spotted a flying saucer, sir.
Evans, radar to Tower A.
Tower A, Nash.
I get a better reading on my scope, Sergeant. That UFO is over the West Sentry post.
Does it look like a flying saucer, Evans?
Yes, it does.
Skyhook control to approaching object. What is it?
I wouldn't know. Capture.
By projecting a highly intermittent and...
Russ, look.
Thing that's watched us since the beginning of the project.
Watched who?
Russ and all the developments of the rocket program.
I always thought it was St. Elmo's fire. I'll have to change my mind about that.
Oh, whatever it was.
Battery, prepare to fire!
They set up an electronic screen. The artillery doesn't penetrate.